chains and food webs. I've been wondering, how do animals know what to eat? And how are they all connected? Let's explore this adventure and learn about food chains and food webs. Oh, I see! The sun provides energy for plants, and then animals eat those plants. But what about animals that eat other animals? That's where food webs come in. In an ecosystem, there are multiple interconnected food chains forming a complex food web. This shows how different plants and animals depend on each other for their food sources. First, we have plants, which are called producers because they produce their own food through photosynthesis using sunlight. Next, we have herbivores, like rabbits and deer. They're called primary consumers because they eat plants directly. Then come the carnivores, or secondary consumers, like foxes, who eat herbivores. And finally, there are tertiary consumers on top of the food chain, like eagles, which eat smaller carnivores. In a food web, this becomes even more complex, with multiple interconnected food chains showing the variety of food sources and consumer relationships in an ecosystem. This is so fascinating. It's amazing to see how every living creature is connected through the food chain and food web. Just as we have our own family food traditions here in Berry Mountain, nature has its own way of creating balance and harmony through food chains and food webs. We're all part of this incredible circle of nourishment. I hope you enjoyed learning about food chains and food webs with me today. Remember, we all play a role in this amazing interconnected world, and understanding how we fit into it helps us respect and protect the environment and all its creatures. Goodie!